Hello and a very good morning to all, wherever you may be joining us around this wonderful country of ours. It is nice of you to do that, first of all, but it's nice to spend some time with you every morning, so thank you for joining in.
Yeah, we appreciate that so much.
Exactly.
It's never, ever, ever lost us. Why are we so happy? Because it's Wednesday.
Exactly.
It's hump day.
That's a beautiful frock. Is that like a Monet?
Monet. Is that like a Monet, but only sort of...
See the correcting.
Oh, okay.
You try with a compliment.
Show me the Monet.
And it's like, you know, treats me like an idiot.
It's beautiful. It looks lovely.
Carl was trying to say it looks
I would have
lovely.
Voted for that.
Deb, you look beautiful.
He's upset with me.
It's none of my work.
Deb.
Well, I'm going to have to
Deb,
spend the next...
You look so stunning this morning.
Thanks, Carl. All the pit crew at the back. They do a tremendous job every morning, our pit
there
crew.
There is,
lovely.
Australia's gold medalist will be here attempting the world's fastest egg and spoon race. Could be messy, Cal and Lisa.
What? No tuned. Underpants, Stevie?
No underpants today. Sorry, what are you talking about? Oh, world record attempt.
You.
I'm with you now.
Yes, last time. Remember?
Personal question to start off the week, isn't it?
Welcome back.
Well, you were wearing about 487 pairs at the time. It was hard to miss, hard to forget as well.
That's right. I'm down 488 from that record today.
Okay, good to see you, Stevie. Thanks for that.
You have to go over hurdles with the egg. That would be a race. Hey, Pedro, just before you go, but if I can just have a...
Please.
You look a little bit pale, a little bit pasty. You okay? Have you been taking your vitamins and stuff?
It's London, Carlos. There's not much sunlight here. It hasn't been for a little while.
Yeah, it's 30 degrees back. Oh, it was in various parts of Australia, so eat that.
Thank you for pointing that out, though.
Nothing like a bit of brother love early in the morning or late at night, your time, Pete.
Mum's over there at the moment too, so he's copying it from both sides.
Maybe that's what it is. I've gone pale from stress.
Yeah, isn't there a story happening in Russia?
Joke. Good morning to you, Jenny, if you're watching on a legal satellite. Leave your mother alone and your brother. Thank you, Pete.
I'm going to go to Russia, Mum.
Great program.
I remember we used to use the trampoline as the wickets when we were growing up.
Oh, did you?
Put the trampoline on its side.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, and then you didn't do that?
Naturally comes back.
Yeah.
We didn't have a trampoline when I was a kid.
Yeah. You know? Well, we didn't have any net on it. It was just the trampoline with springs.
How do you use it as a trampoline?
You imagine that you're jumping.
Explains quite a lot.
It really does. It really
does. Georgie?
Explains a lot of things.
Bit of imagination.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah,
it's what? Good.
Theater landing on your head and stuff like
of
that.
The mind, huh?
We are going to whip around the country to see what's hot.
That's the big decision all these people will have to make when the shop opens at 8 o'clock this morning.
All right, Ashton. Remind them they'll need a new charger as well.
Oh, I think they will by the time the shop opens.
All right, thank you very much. There you go. The early bird
what
catches the worm.
Line.
And the apple.
It's a massive worm.
Big worm.
Wow.
Just goes on and on and on, doesn't it?
That's keen.
You know what? My phone's just fine.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't wake up this morning and think my world's not complete.
There must be hundreds in that line.
Mm. They obviously love them.
A little bit later, I think she's got to walk the whole line, doesn't she?
Well, chat to a few, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, she's got to get to the one on the end and say, "You nuts."
Yeah, yeah. And ask them what their favourite episode of Big Bang Theory was.
Good point.
Well, some familiar faces and some furry faces, that's right. Our old friend Chewbacca. What noise did he make? Chewie, Chewbacca is going to be back. The casting call has gone out. They're looking for a man who's between about 6'8 and 7'5 to go into the Chewbacca suit. I always loved Chewie. He was such a favorite.
Chewie's great. Yeah,
Chewbacca! Chewbacca!
We call him Chewbacca here, but that's...
Oh, Chewbacca?
He hasn't been in any other movies lately, Chewbacca. It'll be great to see him back on the big screen.
You know what? I sometimes chew tobacco.
Chewbacca on the big screen. Yeah, there's something there. Richie, thank you for that. We'll check in with you a little later. Something for everybody in that one.
Isn't that movie that Jabba the Hutt was in?
Jabba the Hutt and Chewbacca.
don't make fun of Richard's accent. That's the way they say it.
Does he say Darth Vader?
Darth! See, he watches the classy version.
It's Monday morning, Richard.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning to you. In just over 5 hours' time, the US government starts running out of money. That's the deadline. Midnight, September 30. She's there. She's got plenty of debt. Here's the US debt clock. You can see it, $16.95 trillion. But don't be surprised if we do see another rate cut by Christmas. Carl, Lisa?
Gee, it doesn't look good, does it?
Doesn't. Yeah. And Ross, can you just explain that special guest appearance there by Cher? Was that like subliminal message of sell your shares?
It was. I think that was pretty much what it was saying. And also Cher, of course, is iconic in America and all that type of stuff. So she is she's got some sort of...
You're making stuff up. Oh, I love it when you do that. Someone pressed the wrong button, that's all. That's
it. Sorry, guys.
Thank you, Ross. Gossip time now.
And maybe a little bit of weather as well.
Yeah, thank you, Stevie. Lisa's just...
I'm gonna give it a go because it's sort of been have a go at Carl Week this week.
All right,
so what am I doing?
Put your knee up there and then go up.
That's as far as I can go.
Right, that's not gonna
work. I've got some killer boots on today. I could really do some damage, actually.
Yeah, you just dig the heel into my back.
Exactly. I tell you what, star jumps would be good this morning. That would keep us warm.
Yes, Johnny boy.
And they're running a competition, a promotion, where you can win tickets and the chance to meet Ricky backstage.
Careful, Ricky. I'll read that again.
All you do is meet him.
Don't promise what you can't deliver.
Wow. Drop into your local coffee club for more details on how you can enter that.
Yeah. Now, next up, a bloke in New York has become an unlikely internet sensation all because of a sexy selfie. So what he did, he met a girl in a cafe, got her phone number. He then decided, I'm going to take a selfie of myself and send it to her. But he accidentally hit the video mode instead of the photo mode. Mm. And so he sent this instead.
Oh.
Right. Creepy, right?
Yeah.
Good looking.
Not sure that he'd be troubling too many women, would he?
Wow. No. So he then decided, well, that's too weird, I'm going to post it online. Yeah. Of course, it went viral.
That's a bit nasty.
Nice. And then, I don't think they expected it, but then all of these copycats have been popping up all over the place. I can't get over
you. He started a trend, Porter.
Yeah, he did. He started a trend. Everyone's having a go at it.
Oh, photo.
That's wrong.
No.
That's sexy.
That's not the idea. Look, it's all such a big day, isn't it, that by the end of the night...
Oh, God, yeah, we were absolutely buggered. It was the last thing on our minds.
Yeah.
Yes. And we'd had hardly anything to drink because we were just... to everyone. And so as soon as we got back to the hotel room, we just... And also because we'd been going out beforehand and all that whole traditional ritual thing. It's like,
All we wanted at the end of our wedding night, and you were there, Georgie, all we wanted, and we had been drinking that day, was just a ham roll.
Really?
Like, we need to eat something. Starving, we've been drinking all day.
Gee, I'm obviously in the minority.
Oh, girl.
Do tell, Georgie.
That's going to say, my biggest thing on the night was I didn't want to take my wedding dress off because I loved it so much.
Oh, you darling.
I loved my dress. But anyway, we got it off in the end.
You did or he did?
He did.
Good. Look, I'm blushing for you.
Over.
What about the dress?
Oh, be quiet, Carl. Moving on.
She's a tigress underneath.
Don't look at me like that.
Self-defense. You know, I look out for you guys in all aspects of your lives, and self-defense is one of these things that is an important skill. Have you guys done anything as anyone?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah? Give us an example, Carl.
Right.
If you were to
demonstrate, Carl.
Pretend you're if you're an attacker, you can stand up, you can sit down, whatever you want. Yeah. If you're to attack dead.
And we do it in slow motion?
Yeah.
So you...
Good stuff. That was great. No, he's fine.
That's an example.
No, that's good.
You did that for a lot of people, Deb.
Holy shit.
That's an example of self-defence. Even better, watch this. Oh, yeah.
She's from Coffs Harbour.
Yeah. Oh.
You've got to know your self-defence up there.
You don't mess with a girl from Coffs. Don't you reckon, Fordo?
How's your hearing out of that ear?
My hearing is, it's a little bit subdued, but I can hear Fordo's stomach rumbling.
Oh.
Can you hear Fordo's stomach?
Whoa.
Can you hear
what
that?
What is that?
Quarto, you okay, buddy?
I think it's actually coming.
From the car park. We're going to tell you all about it in just a second, folks. They're back.